Timor-Leste President Jose Ramos Horta now in the Philippines for a four-day official visit. His trip to Manila seen to strengthen ties between the two countries. Our very own Pia Gutierrez now joins us with an update. Pia, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, the Philippines and East Timor committed to further expand bilateral cooperation during the state visit of East Timor President Jose Ramos Horta in Malacanang Friday. The Timorese leader, who is currently in Manila for a four-day state visit, held bilateral talks with President Marcos Jr. in Malacanang Friday morning, where they discussed ways of strengthening political, educational, and economic partnerships, as well as people-to-people exchanges between Manila and Dili. During their meeting, both leaders directed their governments to reconvene policy consultations expected to further the relations between both countries, as well as study possibilities of having direct flights, establish a bilateral social security agreement for Filipino and Timorese nationals working in each other's countries, and to strengthen educational cooperation between higher learning institutions and increase student exchanges. President Marcos Jr. says the Philippines has also committed to assist Timor-Leste in the skills formation of Timorese people. The Philippine leader also expressed gratitude to President Ramos Horta for his expression of support for the country's adherence to a rules-based international law and to UNCLOS amid ongoing tensions in the West Philippine Sea. President Marcos Jr. also accepted the invitation of Ramos Horta to visit Timor-Leste to further deepen ties between both countries.
You have been a frequent visitor to our country and have made many friends here in the Philippines who are looking forward to seeing you in the time that you are here. I hope that these exchanges will be, this visit of yours will be the beginning of more exchanges between our two countries. And I thank you for the very gracious invitation that you have just extended to me to visit your country. And we would certainly want to do that to, as I said, continue to expand the relations between Timor-Leste and the Philippines. I am very optimistic that your visit here, today will be a very important start to that, the developing that relationship and deepening that relationship between our two countries.
Meanwhile, President Ramos Horta says East Timor, as the only other predominantly Catholic Asian country, has looked to the Philippines in governing their young country. He also expressed his gratitude for the Philippines' earlier support for their country's independence, as well as for Timor-Leste's full membership to the ASEAN. Timor-Leste currently has observer status in the regional bloc, and they intend to attain full membership by the year 2025.
Philippines was very prominent there through the beginning of our independence, and you have been very among the very first country to support our aspiration to join ASEAN. We are now working round the clock to implement the milestones, and we feel confident that we could join. At least between myself and our Prime Minister, Ms. Xanana Guzmán, we have established for ourselves 2025, we should be ready to fully be a member of ASEAN.
Following their meeting, Malacañang is set to host a state banquet in honor of the visiting leader. This is not Ramos Horta's first visit to the Philippines. Prior to this, he had made frequent visits to Manila and other parts of the country. He is expected to depart Manila on Saturday, November 11. Carmina?
Yes, Pia, you mentioned that the Timor-Leste leader said that their country is young. You also said that this is not his first visit to the country. Fact is, Pia, and a lot of the younger generation now don't know this, but really the Philippines played a very important role in Timor-Leste's quest for independence from Indonesia. The partnership between the Philippines and Timor-Leste, the alliance, was there even before they became an independent nation, Pia.
Yes, that's why during their bilateral meeting, if I may add, Carmina, the president of Timor-Leste also noted that the Philippines and East Timor or Timor-Leste actually share a long history of solidarity and support for each other. And during his speech, he particularly thanked the Philippines for being in the forefront way back before their independence, particularly in the critical years of 1999 or during the referendum. He mentioned that the Philippines has dispatched Filipino security forces along with other countries like Malaysia, Thailand, Australia, and New Zealand. And right now, now that they are working to attain full membership of the ASEAN, he said that he is very thankful for the support given by President Marcos Jr. and the entire Philippine government for them to be able to establish themselves as a full ASEAN member by the year 2025, Carmina.
Yeah, Pia, but we also have to make mention here that back when they were in the middle of their quest for independence from Indonesia, the Philippine government then headed by now late President Fidel Ramos Jr., really didn't want to touch the issue with a 10-foot pole if it weren't for the non-government organizations that really propelled the interest of Timor-Leste's independence in the global stage. They wouldn't really have had that leverage to fight for their independence back then, Pia.
That's right, Carmina. And right now, what they want to do is to further expand cooperation by strengthening bilateral ties between the Philippines now that they are they're now an independent country. What President Ramos Horta has said during the bilateral meeting is for them to be able to further this cooperation between the Philippines, not only politically, but also asking the Philippines in assistance, particularly in developing the skills of Timorese people in order for them to govern properly their very young country, Carmina, with the help of the Philippines.
Thanks a lot. Our senior palace correspondent there, Pia Gutierrez, joining us on the line. Thanks, Pia. I really appreciate it. Another act of aggression by China in the West Philippine Sea. See, Chinese boats once again tried to block a Philippine vessel on a resupply mission to the BRP Sierra Madre in Ayungan Shoal Friday morning. The Chinese boats made unsafe maneuvers to prevent the Philippine ship from advancing. Just last month, the Chinese Coast Guard rammed Philippine vessels that were also on a resupply mission in Ayungan Shoal. China claims nearly the whole South China Sea. This has been rejected by an international tribunal back in 2016. The National Task Force on the West Philippine Sea condemns the latest act of aggression by China in the West Philippine Sea. Philippine officials confirmed that the Chinese Coast Guard and Chinese militia vessels executed dangerous maneuvers in an attempt to block a Philippine resupply mission to the BRP Sierra Madre in Ayungan Shoal Friday morning. The National Task Force on the West Philippine Sea says the Philippine Embassy in Beijing has protested China's actions. The task force asserts the Chinese vessel should leave the vicinity of Ayungan Shoal immediately. It adds the Philippines will not be deterred from exercising its legal rights over its maritime zones. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. seemed to play a crucial role in bringing up regional maritime issues in the upcoming APEC summit in San Francisco. Political scientist Clive Argelias says the Philippines should lead such efforts as it faces constant Chinese harassment in the West Philippine Sea. While in the U.S., Marcos will also visit the Indo-Pacific Command headquarters in Hawaii in a display of the deepening alliance between Manila and Washington.
This is something that's quite unprecedented. It's not usual for a head of state, the president, to visit the regional commander of a foreign military. This really only signals that they want to publicly portray clearly to the players in the region that the U.S. is locked in with, that the Philippines is locked in with the U.S. in terms of issues in the West Philippine Sea and related foreign policy issues.